We sure loved the Jim Sorensen concert when we had it up here. That was wonderful. Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome to Unity of Payson, everyone online and everyone here in person. If online you heard some weird sounds, we are having a little bit of technical challenge this morning. And so everyone here in person, please be sure all your cell phones are silenced. And if you're online, please be sure everyone is muted. We sometimes forget that when we're talking, other people can hear us on the other side of the country. So let's take just a minute to allow all that busyness that's been going on to just sort of drift away, take a deep breath, to be here present. At a time, a short prayer this morning. We come together in gratitude that we have this lovely space to meet in, and our presence and intention creates it as sacred space. We are grateful for community. We are grateful for divine wisdom. And for discernment, we open our minds and our hearts to the message this morning, knowing that the potential for a shift in who we are and how we believe is always possible. Grateful for all of this, and so it is. Well, thank you all for being here again. And in case you don't know, my name's Betty, and I'll be hosting this morning. Reverend Neil and Donna are on a little weekend getaway. And so we are it this morning. And we have, at first, an opening song from Karen Drucker, Song in My Soul. And if I can encourage anybody to stand and sing with me.
You can at least stand.
There is a song in my soul, it sings I am whole. Everywhere I go, it sings I am whole. There is a song in my soul, it sings I am whole. Everywhere I go, it sings I am whole. I am whole. There is a song in my soul, it sings I am healed. I take a breath and know that I am healed. There is a song in my soul, it sings I am healed. I take a breath and know that I am healed. There is a song in my heart, it sings I am loved. It whispers in my ear that I am loved. There is a song in my heart, it sings I am loved. It whispers in my ear that I am loved. I am loved.
I am
love.
I am love.
I am joy.
I am joy.
joining in and playing this morning. If you're online, I'm sorry. I hope you're dancing in your room. Well, welcome everyone. I can't see if you are new online. If you are, we invite you to put a little hello in the chat. And for everyone else, I recognize everyone else here in the room. And so I invite you all to stay after for some refreshments and we can get to know everybody a little better. And so whether you are new, whether you have yet to find us, or let's just take the time to bless each other. And so together, we love you, we bless you, and we welcome you. I guess it would help to turn the mic on. Okay, and we have gratitudes. Besides being grateful that you're all here with us this morning, we're grateful that you help support this ministry. And we had activities, of course, we have them every week. We encourage everybody to check the Monday email with everything going on, because we have a couple big events coming up that I have some flyers on later, we'll announce. But this past week, of course, we had our usual morning cafe. We had the Qigong and Tai Chi, and of course, cards and games every Thursday afternoon over at Kay's house. Very fun, very well attended. And we're thankful for technology. I'm holding a good thought, everyone, good thoughts that all the technology works for the rest of service this morning. So Unity is grounded in affirmative prayer and in meditation. And we have trained prayer chaplains. Marianne is here, I am here, and I think that's it for this morning. If you have a prayer request, do not hesitate to ask for support. You can see one of us after service, or anyone online or during the week. You can email your prayer request to neil.unityofpayson@gmail.com. And we hold them sacred and confidential in prayer for 30 days, and then they get sent on to Silent Unity where they are held for another 30 days. So do avail yourself of this opportunity. And our theme this month. Our theme is integrity. And boy, what a wide subject that is. So let's say the affirmation together. My words and actions are in harmony with my values. I am whole and complete. I don't know about you, but sometimes I say something and went, okay, universe, erase that one. We'll repeat in a more positive note. And so our speaker today is lovely Reverend Julianne, and from Interfaith Community in Mesa. And her talk title is The Power of Our Words. As I think, I believe it, and I become it. And how true that is. Reverend Julianne serves at Interfaith Community. She has a lively and passionate approach to New Thought ministry, A Course in Miracles, and the study of major world religions. Reverend Julianne offers insightful and inspired teaching that entertains, illuminates, and challenges, sparking spiritual growth. And the website for Interfaith is interfaith-community.org to stay on top of what is going on. I know all of you online wait with bated breath to see what Julianne has for you. And our daily word for today is ease. And let's say this affirmation together too. Beholding God in every circumstance helps me know ease. When I saw this morning that this was going to be the daily word, actually I looked yesterday, I thought, oh, this should have been up last month when we were doing grace and ease. Okay. It's easy for me to find God in the glory of a sunrise and in the laughter of children, and to feel God's love as I get together with friends or family. Wherever there is wonder, joy, or fellowship, God is surely present, and that part's easy. I remember that God is just as surely present when my responsibilities feel overwhelming, when conflict arises in a relationship, or when it feels as though there isn't enough of what I need. If I begin to feel tense, fearful, or frustrated, I remember that wisdom, love, understanding, and strength, all of the divine qualities that live within me, are ready to help me handle any challenge. Assured by my awareness of God's presence, I move with ease and grace through whatever this day brings. And from Proverbs, those who listen to me will be secure and will live at ease. And how easy it is to remember that God moves through our life when everything's going fine. And when, you know what, hits the fan, sometimes it's a challenge to remember, oh, this is God's presence also. And so what is it about this situation? How can I learn from this? How can I move forward with it? And choose to shift how you feel, how you speak about that. And that leads into our talk title of integrity. And so now we have Reverend Julianne with her talk.
Good morning, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
It's wonderful to be here and to share with all of you. And I really recognize when Betty was talking about the sound challenges and the Zoom challenges, because we've been
Zooming for a while. For Lori Elward.
Okay, let's take a look.
See what I mean?
Yeah.
But the reality of it is that Zoom, we look at them and we think they're seeming distance. We look at you and we see some of you not sitting, quote unquote, next to each other. We think there's a seeming distance. The reality is that we're together, spiritually together, connected. So even if there is a sound issue, we can overcome that. Now, last week, I shared about life is grace, and that gift of grace is within each one of us. Even the pup that was here earlier, that grace is life. And we're called to be the grateful receiver of that gift. And when we accept the gift, we recognize the love and the creativity and the connection that we share. With an increased awareness of grace, I'm giving myself permission to recognize, as Frederick Buchner wrote, the grace of God means something like, here is your life. You might never have been, but you are, because the party wouldn't have been complete without you. So grace calls me, and yes, each of us, to acknowledge that we are not human beings on a spiritual journey. We are spiritual beings on a human journey, and we have accepted the invitation to the party. So I have to ask myself, how am I showing up? How am I showing up to the party? How am I showing up to this lifetime? To answer the question honestly, I have learned to accept a deeper commitment to Holy Spirit's call, a call for mindfulness. And I ask myself daily, how am I showing up to this party, to this lifetime? I am aware that spiritually, I am divinely connected to the light within all. And I'm aware that physically in the material world, the one thing that nobody else has is me. My mind, my story, my voice, my material world expression is uniquely mine. Now, I also have to take responsibility that I write that story. I sing my song. All of us are here, old enough here to know who Frank Sinatra was. Remember his song, My Way? Mm-hmm. In other words, to be at the party, as only I can be. And yes, to love, to laugh, and to cry. And this is where the call to mindfulness speaks loudly. Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu said, "Watch your thoughts, they become your words. Watch your words, they become your actions. Watch your actions, they become your habits. Watch your habits, they become your character. Watch your character, it becomes your destiny." Lao Tzu really shared with us in that short paragraph the power of our words and the effect that our words share in our lifetime experience at this party. At this party with everyone. Now, words are not simply sounds. Words have real power. And they have an impact on us as well as others. They can be gentle, they can be loving, they can be supportive, or they can be harsh, they can be judgmental, they can be negative, and yes, fearful. Words are tools that make life better. But as many of us know, any tool in our toolbox can be misused. So we must choose to be more conscious. We must let go of words and phrases that are insensitive or harmful. The Apostle Paul wrote in Ephesians, "Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths." And what is helpful for building others up according to needs, that is what may benefit those who listen. I read that probably a half a dozen times before I typed it in. And I was realizing that I am listening too. It's not just what I'm saying to you. It's what I'm saying to me and what I'm saying to all. So you kind of have to take that deep breath in and say, we're at this party. We're here to experience the feelings of love, joy, peace, kindness, and gratitude, and to let them in our heart and use them in love so that more people are welcome and comfortable at this party. We are creating and we are sharing. And then in scripture, it goes on in the Gospel of Matthew to remind us that for out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. The good person out of his good treasure brings forth good. Our words can share the gift of God's grace and the indwelling of Holy Spirit in our lives. Our words are full of blessings when the heart is full of blessings, which it is due to God's abundant grace. However, we have a choice, don't we? We can accept and share God's grace, or we can pretend it's not there and block it. So what I'd like us to do today is really have an open mind and tune into the power and the grace that is always present and use that transformative loving energy that's in our heart for a stronger transformative opportunity to have the willingness to understand and accept our spiritual truth and that truth in each other. When we have done that, we have an increased awareness of our value and the importance of sharing our goodness at this party. Do we listen to the gentle whispers of our inner wisdom to bring forth the good? Not that all the time. I do quite a bit, but not all the time. So I have to remind myself to stay mindful. I have to remind myself that my thoughts and my words give. And thus, am I giving the good, the beautiful, and the holy, or not? In thought, word, and actions, through the power of our words, we are the possibility for the holy shift on this planet. And this planet is calling for it. Now, our gift of grace shares a loving energy to conceive it, to express, to enjoy the blessings of our creative power, and we create. We must remember through thought, word, and deed. We're here to absolutely recognize and acknowledge that we can reveal the creative ideal of the divine. Now, one of my favorite authors, and one of the very few I recommend, is Don Miguel Ruiz. In his book, The Four Agreements, he wrote, "Be impeccable with your word. Speak with integrity. Use the power of your word in the direction of truth and love." That's a call to each one of us. Being impeccable with our word is a good use of our energy. It means that we use our energy in the direction of truth and kindness. Yes, for ourselves and for others. I truthfully do believe that we all make a difference here in the world, in our party. But we do so by our presence and by our interaction. And it is therefore of very great importance that we dedicate ourselves to being in integrity. Now, from my perspective, integrity is a determination of the heart, an unwavering determination to do right. When I am afraid, I must do right. When I'm not afraid, I must do right. When my emotions tried to lead me another way, I must choose integrity and do right. When my emotions are doing fine, I must do right. When people like it, I must do right. When people don't like it, I must do right. That's integrity. In doing right, we are called to be impeccable with our word. So, are you impeccable with your word? Or do your words tend to roll around in your head a little bit and even come out of your mouth before you thought about it being right? I know I do that. I react. I had this idea the other day, and I imagined a loudspeaker. I don't really like loudspeakers, but I imagined one attached to the very top of my head. And through that speaker, every thought and every feeling was broadcast and nothing was censored.
Ooh.
Ooh. You bet. Ooh. You know, when I thought about that, I wanted to just, and maybe never open my mouth again. But then I realized it's not just my words, it's my thoughts, it's my feelings. Oh boy. This is what I believe is really happening 24 hours a day. We have the happy dream at night? Yes. We have the nightmare at night? Yes. It goes through that loudspeaker. Ouch. Of course, we are listening. And of course, the energy goes out. And everybody who attracts themselves to the forces and influence determined by those thoughts, those emotions, those words, wow. So we have to be grateful. When we recognize that our thoughts, words, and feelings are negative, we change our thinking and we do right. I'm reminded to become more conscious, more aware, to look inside more and affirm my intention of maintaining an open heart and cultivating a mental stillness to accept clear thinking and peace of mind. Now, if I can do that, I'm going to express myself in more appropriate and loving ways. Or as I say, I'm going to express the best through that loudspeaker and through my mouth. The word, I believe, is the most powerful tool that we have as a human. And Don Miguel says, but like a sword with two edges. Your word can create the most beautiful dream, or your word can destroy everything around you. If you want to change your life around, that first agreement you have to make with yourself to be impeccable with your word. A direct, thought-provoking statement. The word impeccable comes from the Latin root of peccatus, which means sin. And the I am, and impeccable, means without. So impeccable means without sin. Now, sin to me is error. Sin is a mistake. It's missing the mark. And sin, as Don Ruiz explains it, is anything you do that goes against yourself. Anything you do that goes against yourself. Are you willing to recognize yourself and the connection of yourself with others? Everything you do goes against yourself. So be impeccable with your word implies not going against yourself. It's about speaking with integrity. It's about using words that empower your confidence by refraining from those words to put others down, or to speak negatively about yourself, or to be critical of, hey, you out there. It's about saying only what you mean. It's about using your words to focus your attention on what you want most. Love. Love instead of fear. When you are impeccable with your word, you will experience less negative energy in your daily life. You'll have less conflict with the people around you. And most importantly, you're going to speak words of compassion, words of optimism to yourself. And you're going to plant seeds of self-love in that fertile mind, your heart mind. And then you do right and you share love. And you do right and you share love. Together as one, I am saying that we are called to express the love of God in every corner of our life. That our words reflect the pure goodness of spirit. And that we make the affirmation to live by the qualities of openness, integrity, and compassion. May we accept and always remember that the divine is living. Living grace shared through us. So we say, thank you, God. Thank you, God, in us. Thank you, God, forever. Amen.
As we prepare for meditation, meditation song is by Daniel Neymar. Amen.
A simple, silent prayer, a single word of praise is true from anywhere, is heard from any place. So right where I stand, say amen, say amen. Right where I am, say amen, say amen, say. On wings. wings of sacred love. So right where I stand, I say amen, say amen. Right where I am, I say amen, say.
Now we begin, affirming the divine grace within our spiritual self. So listen to your breath, feel the breath. And if you're comfortable in closing your eyes, please do. If not, focus on one particular item and gently settle in. Be comfortable. Become aware of your breathing. And give yourself permission to picture a beautiful morning. The sky is clear. There's a gentle warm breeze, and you feel comfortable. You recognize your true treasures within your soul, your creativity, your love, your peace, the gifts of God's grace. Those gifts which you rise with in the morning, and you look out and you see that beautiful day. You feel comfortable. And you look up and you see a beautiful cloud. You smile, and as you smile, the cloud smiles back at you and opens its tears that gently, slowly fall, touching you, gently, your head, your neck, and you relax, feeling that gentle flow of water easily down on your head, easily down on your shoulders, gently over your back. You relax, and it flows over your chest, your stomach. You take another deep breath in, and you feel your stomach, your chest, your back release, relax. And now the water moves gently over your legs, down to your feet, and again you feel that beauty, that comfort, and you relax. That wonderful warm water gently touching, releasing and letting go, refreshing you. That water slowly moving from you into the earth. Your body is at ease, your mind is peaceful. And you feel the earth beneath you relax. You're taking in another deep breath. Take it in, hold it for a moment, and release. And again, you look up and you see the clouds above you, and through them, a beautiful golden ray of light. That light shining down, touching the very top of your head. And the kindness and generosity within your heart mind, you feel that light flowing through you, blessing you gently. You imagine that light as it enters your body, every cell peacefully filled, gently energized. You are a golden radiance. You see your body aglow. Each and every cell, every molecule of your being is feeling this golden light energy, the energy of grace, of love, of peace, of creativity. See the beauty within this light. See the beauty within you as this light. See this beauty of this light in you flowing into Mother Earth. And now you see a beam of your light. You see it within your heart. And you take another deep breath in. And as you gently release it, you send that beam of light to another person that is with you this morning. With you personally in the same space, or with you personally in your heart. You see that light gently entering their heart, touching them with love, with beauty, with peace. And now as you look at them, you see that that beam of light in them goes to another, and to another, and to another. And now that light beam connects with the hearts of every person that we know, every person that we love, every person that we think about. The grace of love, the grace of peace, the grace of creativity, and a renewed awareness of the power of our thoughts, of our words, of our actions. With an open heart mind, we see the people with hands raised, sharing this light of grace with all living beings. We are all connected, radiant with a golden divine light, a golden love from and through all that is. We feel the radiance of the divine grace. We feel the reunion, the oneness. We feel the energy and the peace and the beauty of the light that we are as one. And gratefully, we accept the love. We accept that we are wholly loving. We accept the peace. We accept our authentic self. We feel that love that we are. And yes, we gratefully bless each other. We're grateful to our brothers and sisters of Unity of Payson and Interfaith Community. We are grateful. And with that gratitude, we take in another deep breath and release it. And one more and release it. And now we feel the slow breath, the one of comfort and ease. And when you open your eyes, around your space, feel the gratitude, feel the beauty, feel the truth of who you are. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Julianne. Everybody, let's take another deep breath. It feels like we need a few more moments to get back here present. I love it when we have deep meditations, longer ones. So thank you.
Yeah.
And during your talk, what immediately flashed on me was Dr. Emoto's work with the water crystals.
Yes.
How they proved that consciousness, your negative thoughts, destroy those beautiful crystals and does the same thing to all of us. So like you said, besides watching our words, let's watch our thoughts. That was a scary image, though, of every thought I have being broadcast out. I'm like, okay.
When I thought of it, I thought of somebody else that does it quite frequently.
No names.
No names.
Okay, so now it is the time for our gifts and our offerings. We're grateful for all the support. As we support the larger community then. And in a moment, we'll have an offering song, and in person, we'll be passing the basket. And if you're online, the slides for how to give are up. And for Unity of Payson, you go to unityofpayson.org, and you can go to the donate button. And for interfaith community, that is the same. It's interfaith-community.org, and also go to their donate button. And so let's hold all those wonderful thoughts from Julianne's talk and charge your offering up so that everyone that benefits from what you are giving gets that blast of beautiful, peaceful, compassionate energy as they receive it. And so let's hold that in our hearts. And we say our affirmation together. Freely we give and freely receive. And the offering song is from Willie Nelson, Energy Follows Thought. I don't think I've heard this one.
Imagine what you want, then get out of the way. Remember, energy follows thought, so be careful what you say. Be careful what you ask for, make sure it's really what you want, because your mind is made for thinking, and energy follows thought. Your mind is in control, even when you do not know. And if you let it idle, ain't no telling where it'll go. Whenever you are sleeping and your dreams take you away, go on with your dreaming and listen to what they say. If you hear spirits talking, their wisdom can't be bought. Apply it to your thinking, and energy follows thought. Telling where it'll go. imagine what you are and get out of the way. Remember, energy follows thought, so be careful what you say.
I like it. Never heard it before, but that was a great song. Ah, and so we are grateful for the gifts and for all of the givers online and here in person, and all the volunteers. We sometimes forget to say, yay, Terry, woohoo, for the AV stuff. And Rick, Marianne, who's always here. Joanne, I see you back there helping. And Charlotte, thank you so very much. And Manny, Reverend Manny, thank you for being in support of Reverend Julianne in life. So, I don't know where all those came from, but now's the time to dedicate our offering. And I think there's a couple of new words, so watch the words as they come through. Together, divine love flowing through us blesses and multiplies all that we are, all that we have, all that we give, and all that we receive. We are abundantly prosperous, and we are grateful, and so it is. All righty. Let's see, are we doing connection time? Did we get the camera to work?
I need the camera.
Rick, are we doing connection time with the camera?
Yes, sorry.
We'll try.
We'll try. Everyone online, we hope this works because we were having some problems. So
we're just going to do it manually today.
Scan the room. So slow down as it comes by. Oh,
there we go.
Yeah, we need to go to the
camera. Maybe you can stop the shooter. I can see the camera, but.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay.
All right. The
wave when it comes by.
Okay. Here we go. There we go.
Hello, everybody.
Wave.
All right. Thank you.
Okay. Hello.
And when we at the end of service, then we will unmute everyone. And in the meantime, you can at least put your camera on, everyone online, and wave at us. And in just a few minutes, you'll be able to say hi to everybody as we unmute you. So, okay. So next Sunday, of course, the theme continues on with integrity. And the speaker next Sunday will be Reverend Neil Worthington, and his talk title is, Who Are You Anyway? Good question. And most of our meetings are all on Zoom unless it's stated otherwise. And so we have our regulars. I'll just review them quickly here. Monday through Saturday at 9:30 online is the Morning Cafe. The Qigong Tai Chi is with Teresa is Sunday and Wednesday at 4:30 in the afternoon. Cards and Games at K's every Thursday at 1:00. And the next gathering at K's will be September 11th, and that will be a self-agio chime meditation. So any of you who haven't experienced that yet, that it's a really wonderful deep meditation, a silent one. And then of course there's always organic gardening at Shanti Olmsted, and I have a flyer about that here. And next we have A Course in Miracles with Reverend Neil. That's Tuesday, September 6th from 6 to 7:30. And of course that is a Zoom meeting. And all of these are on a love offering basis. And next we have the writers group for everybody that loves to write. And that's a Thursday, September 8th from 4 to 5 in the evening. And that's the second and fourth Thursday of the month. Next, we have on that same day, but later on in the evening, the World Day of Prayer service. And that's in coordination with Unity Worldwide. They actually start the 24-hour vigil the day before, and then this is at the completion of that. And so you can either join that on Zoom or in person here. They will be showing the video of the speakers and the songs and the prayer service. And next we have a fall event at Shanti Olmsted, and this is going to be the Equinox celebration. So I'll put this on the back table. It's a flyer, but there are smaller handouts in the back if you want to pick one up. And so there'll be music. Let's see. Join us for a festive celebration of food and community at Shanti Olmsted, which is down in Geisela. And just touring his organic farm is just so wonderful. And campfire songs with Cinnamon Twist. And I think I'm getting roped into doing a drumming circle also. So there'll be lots of fun that day. And so it's the farm tour is at 4. At 5 o'clock is the community potluck, the feast. At 6:30 is campfire songs. So it sounds like a really good time, especially for all of those people that really be wanting to get together in person and do something. So be sure to pick up the little flyer in the back. Okay. They would like to know, let's see, I'm sure it says it on the small handout, to register and say what dish you might want to bring for the potluck so they can plan on that. And there will be finally a new member class. Neil's been having quite a few requests for this. Wednesday, September 28th and October 5th at 5 o'clock in person and on Zoom. Please see Reverend Neil if you'd like to become a member and get to that class. And there is no PS from Reverend Neil, but I do have one more announcement. And this is actually from the Methodist Church here. They are going to have a flu and COVID shot clinic September 18th at 11:30 after church. And so that'll be in this room. So that Sunday we'll have to clean up kind of quick so they can do that. But it's a really great opportunity. And so the flyer for that will also be in the back so you can put it in your calendar. So I think that was quite a few. I think it's time to circle up for the peace song and the prayer for protection.
Let's see, in this case, oval up. Whatever it is.
Yeah. I'm ready to start.
Yeah, we're good.
Yes. And yes, it begins with me. Yes, there is peace on earth, a peace that was meant to be. With God as Creator, family all are we. Now we walk with each other in earth.
Thank you for protection. Are we?
So, I'm gonna start. Give me one second. I just killed the switch.
The light of God.
The light of God surrounds us. I am light.
Power.
The love of God enfolds us. I am love.
The power of God.